Hello students, welcome back to the next session on basic electrical and electronics engineering. We are discussing about the topic known as a DC circuit, and today we are going to discuss about a point in detail, that is nothing but Kirchhoff's laws statement, that is nothing but KVL and KCL. Please mind, we are not going to discuss about how to solve a numerical using Kirchhoff's law in this particular session. Today I will only introduce you with a statement of Kirchhoff's law. Actually, Kirchhoff's is the one of the scientists who have defined and two different laws related to electrical engineering. The first law is known as a KVL and another law is known as a KCL, where K stands for Kirchhoff's and VL stands for voltage law and CL stands for current law. So Kirchhoff's voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law. So these are those two laws. Now let's see what he defined in an Kirchhoff's current law. See, this is what he defined in case of Kirchhoff's current law. At any particular junction point or node, the algebraic sum of current is always equal to zero. See, that is nothing but how mathematically we can represent it. We can represent it like this. Summation of I is always equal to zero at a junction. Please remember, at junction is a keyword. This is very important because it is applicable only at a junction. Now, this particular statement says that here algebraic sum of a current we are considering. What is algebraic sum? Algebraic sum is nothing but incoming currents are considered as a positive. You can see that I2, I3, I4, these three are incoming current. That's why these three current are considered as a positive, whereas outgoing currents are considered as negative. So I1 and I5, as you can see, they are going away from a junction. That's why these two currents are considered as outgoing current and outgoing currents are considered as negative. So I can write an algebraic sum of this particular as like this, I1, but it should be minus because it is outgoing current, plus I2, that is positive because it is incoming, plus I3, it is incoming, that's why I consider it as a plus, plus I4 because it is again incoming, minus I5 is equal to zero. So this is the equation which says that at this particular junction A, this particular equation is applied, where I1 and I5 are negative because they are outgoing current, I2, I3, I4 are positive because they are incoming current. Now that's why this particular equation can be rewritten as like this: summation of incoming current is always equal to summation of outgoing current. Rather, this is the proper definition of Kirchhoff's voltage, or rather Kirchhoff's current law. Why? Because this is based on the concept known as law of conservation of energy. What law of conservation of energy state? It says that energy is neither created nor destroyed, it only changes its form. So here the electricity is also a form of energy. We cannot create it or we cannot destroy it. So that's why summation of energy coming at particular point A, as at particular point A there is no storage of the energy, entire incoming energy will be sent as an outgoing energy because energy is neither created nor destroyed. That's why at point A we cannot destroy electricity or we cannot create electricity at point A. That's why incoming current is always equal to outgoing current. So this is about Kirchhoff's current law, and this is the statement of Kirchhoff's law. Again, I am defining it. Kirchhoff's current law state that the algebraic sum of a current at any particular junction or node is always equal to zero. Now let's proceed to the second law. So this is a Kirchhoff's voltage law. As the name indicate, KVL, it indicate Kirchhoff's voltage law. Now again, what Kirchhoff's voltage law says? This is the statement of Kirchhoff's voltage law. Algebraic sum of EMF and voltage drops, algebraic sum of EMFs and voltage drops in a closed loop is always equal to zero, is always equal to zero. But like that, in previous case it was at a junction, this law is applicable in closed loop. So this is the important point, it is only applicable in closed loop. So in any closed loop, you can see that if I name this particular loop as A, B, C, D, then we can define this particular loop as A, B, C, D, A. As starting point and ending point are same, that's why it is a loop. So in this particular loop, algebraic sum of EMF means voltage sources. How many voltage sources are there? Only one, V1. And there are three voltage drop. You can see that V1, V2, V3. So that's why algebraic sum of all these three are always equal to zero. So we can write, or in fact, we can write it like this also. Summation of voltage drop is equal to, rather it can be written it like this, summation of voltage drop across a resistance is equal to summation of all EMF or voltage sources applied across it, right? So this is the definition of a Kirchhoff's voltage law. Now how we can write an equation for this? V1 plus V2 plus V3 is equal to V4, where what is V1, V2, V3? It is IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3 R3 is equal to V4. That is, voltage applied in this particular loop is equivalent to voltage drops in this particular loop. So entire voltage V1 or rather V4 will get dropped across different resistors in this particular circuit. So this is what we can call it as a Kirchhoff's voltage law. So this is Kirchhoff's voltage law. I hope you understood that statement of Kirchhoff's current law and Kirchhoff's voltage law. In next session, we will see some numerical based on Kirchhoff's law. Till then, please be safe. Thank you.